Hello friends, myself Rajesh here. I taken this resource from a VTU website, which is created by assistant professor Suresh. In this lecturing, what I am going to discuss about is what is theory of machine and machines, theory of mechanisms and machines. See, if you are going to design, basically I am a mechanical engineer. And I'm going to take a topic of design now. Suppose if you are going to create any machine, we need to follow the theory behind that. That is theory of machines. That is theory of machines. The theory of machines are again classified into a kinematics of machines and a dynamics of machines. In kinematics of machines, we are going to study about a study of motions of a component and a basic geometry of mechanisms, and it is not concentrated with the forces. We not to design any machine components. First we are going to decide what are the elements which is coming across in a machine, and how we are going to make a constraint of each and every elements, and how the motion of the each and every elements will takes place. For example, I am going to take a machine of shaper. In a shaper, if you are going to supply a torque by means of a motor, that rotary motion is converted into a linear motion of a ramp. For converting of rotary motion into a linear motions of a ramp, you need to have some mechanism, some links and all. Okay, that motions and different types of constraints, what we are going to each and every link we are going to concentrating in kinematics of machines. And second part in a theories of machines are dynamics of machines. In this dynamics of machines, we are concentrating about what are the forces and couple which is acting on each and every link of a machine. Then only we can understand what are the forces which is exerting on a machine and what are the materials we are going to select with this much of force which is exerted on a machine. Okay, let me explain you. See, these are all the some examples of static force analysis. First is energy transmission, examples of other static force analysis. Energy transmitted, force due to assembly, force due to applied load, force due to change in temperature, impact force, spring force, belt and pulley, weight of different parts. See, and I'll take what are the forces which is acting on each and every link. See, you just see, this is a one type of link. Okay, it may be of a single link, may be of a single element, or it may be made up of two or three elements, assembly of two or three elements. See, and if a machine which consisting of number of parts, even though some of the parts will be acted by compression force and some of the parts will be acted by tensile force and some of the parts will be acted by torsional force. Let me explain. I will take two components. See, one link which is acted by a compression force, and the same link, some position, it will acted by tensile force. This is very important for designing of a machine. See, FA, I'll take the first compression force. In this, FA and FB, which is acting in opposite direction, it will cause compressing of the material will take place. Compression of material will take place. Usually, the compression force can be told like this. Two equal and opposite pushes which will take place to a member. Two equal and opposite forces which is acting along an axis, it will cause compression forces. That means change in the length, decreasing in length and increasing in its volume. Here in tensile forces, two equal and opposite forces acting opposite direction. That means two pulling forces exerted in a tensile force. Two pulling forces which is exerted in a tensile force. This will create increase in its length and decrease in its diameter. These two are of rigid link, and these are all the how the material will behave. If the two forces is acting like this, the material will not move as the Newton's first law of motion. Okay, if A body will maintain its state of rest or uniform motion unless and until it is compared by means of external force. For that, this is applicable. See, this body is in rest on the floor and the load is applied to this. For oppositing of that load, another load is acting on downwards, the surface direction which is exerted by the floor. This will not be an equal, then the body will not be remain in the same position. It will changes or it may be fall down. Like that, these are all the examples of gear machine. Okay. For dynamics and dynamics of machine or theories of machines will be applicable for each and every designing of each and every components. See, for this it's a small material or small part which is placed in a table. For this it's a gear mechanism. Gear mechanism used for transmitting of power. You know that. And these are all the some conditions are there. These are all some important conditions are there. Three important conditions we are going to undergo. First is equilibrium of a body under the action of two forces. This is similar. Okay. If the two forces which is acting to a same body and the direction of the two forces is in same sign, the line of action, the line of action of two forces is same, then the body will be remains in the same state of rest. So, and if the two in this, if the three forces which is acting on a member and the line of action of these three forces will be coincided at a point, then the body will be in remain in stationary condition. Like that, torque also. Torque is nothing but two equal and opposite forces acting to a material. It will cause torsional load. Acceleration in this you will get angular acceleration of the body. Okay, let me explain one mechanism which is a slider crank mechanism which is usually asked in a VTU fifth semester. Now it's a fifth semester, we have dynamics of machine, same similar method they are going to ask. Sometimes they are going to ask a derivations and sometimes they are going to ask a problem. Okay, this is a problem. Now see, it's a single slider crank mechanism. That means one slider is there and other three links will be there. Okay, totally it's a four link mechanism. And here the slider is constrained. Here the slider is constrained. And this link 3 we call it as connecting rod and link 2 is a crank. If you are going to apply a load on P, what will happen? The slider will slides here and the connecting rod will changes its position. And as well as with respect to this connecting rod and a slider, the crank will also changes. Our aim is to maintain the static equilibrium condition. That means it should be maintained in this position only. That time we are going to apply the force on link 2. That means torque, in terms of torque. That means the motor which is connected here, it will supply the torque. That should overcome this force and the force acted by this because of inertia force. Then it should be in equilibrium condition. Okay, this finish of this with slider crank mechanism. Thank you.